In this video, I'm going to try to make an AI for a very complex card game. I'm gonna need it to be efficient enough to run each move in under a single second. But my computer's pretty good, so I'm gonna need to run it on the worst computer I can get my hands on. My mom's laptop. Before I actually started making stuff, I spent a good month rewriting the whole game logic in C#. And let me explain why. Now, I went to a very helpful Discord community for C# and I asked around. And apparently we can get 5 to 20 times performance by using C# instead of Godot's GD script. For example, if I can make my bot 10 times faster, that means that instead of the player having to wait 10 seconds for the bot to make a move, they're only going to have to wait for 1 second. So I actually made a bunch of cards when I first started to prototype this game. In total, I made 4 decks. So now I just gotta put all these cards into the game. Thank you to my Discord members for helping me name these cards. And now I need your help. What should I name this card? Let me know in the comments. I've rewritten the entire game logic in C# now, and I've also coded in all the cards. And now I've created a bot. And the way it works is through an algorithm called MCTS. And what this does is it takes the list of possible moves, and in order to decide which one of those moves is the best one, it runs a certain number of game simulations on each move, where it plays out a game against itself. And then, depending on the win rate that each move led to, it picks out the best move. And the way I implemented this bot is I actually didn't. I just copied a GitHub repo for the bot. And right now, I'm showing you how fast my bot is, which is not that fast as you can see. There's still a lot of room for improvement here. So let's see if we can make it faster. So I just found out that the code for the bot has a multi-threaded implementation. So look at how much faster we get just by changing our function from search to parallel search. So that's very, very cool, guys. I'm so happy. But remember, it's still gonna have to run on my mom's laptop. And her laptop has like 4 cores maybe, so we'll see. Now the question is, can we make this even faster now? See, there's 2 things we can do to improve our bot. The first thing is to improve our bot. And the second thing is to make it run faster. Because if it runs faster, we can do more simulations. And more simulations is also equal to better bot. Whenever we create a card, we have to read from a JSON file. And that takes a bit of time, you know, but I don't know if we can optimize it necessarily. Or can we? Actually, or can we? So the problem is every time we draw a card, it reads its contents from a JSON file. And we're running thousands of simulations, and in each new simulation, it's gonna draw new cards that it's already drawn in other simulations. Instead of reading the same JSON files over and over again, we're gonna preload all these JSON cards into objects, and then each new card can just clone these objects instead.
I'm done. I'm about to run it. I'm a bit nervous. Let's press play. What the? Look at that, guys. Just look at that. Just look. Look at how fast they're going. What is going on? This is actually crazy. It's over. He lost. Game over. Yeah, I guess with that, we have way, way better performance. And here's what we're gonna do, okay? Same bot, but instead of running 1,000 simulations, we're gonna do 5,000. 1,000 versus 5,000. And we're gonna see how they compare. You know, we just got an 8 times performance improvement, so I think 5 is pretty fair. That means we're still saving time and we're making a better bot. And that's why I was saying, before we make improvements to the actual bot, we can just make improvements to the performance. So we're gonna see what the win rate is for our new bot versus our old bot. I created this tournament. Each bot is gonna play with the 4 different decks, and then I wanted to automatically generate an Excel file of all the win rates of each deck.
The results are in. We have our CSV file, and it looks like we have a 58% win rate with our new 5,000 simulations bot versus 1,000. That's a very good win rate, and it all came from being able to improve the performance of our code. Originally, I actually had plans to build up a neural network to train our bot with, but sadly, I had a lot of technical issues there, and we're running out of time. In a future episode, we'll be revisiting the AI and making it really good. But for now, this is good enough. It's time to run the ultimate test. The goal is for the average move time to be below 1 second, but we also have a secondary goal of having a max move time that's less than 2 seconds. So I'm ready, guys. You ready? Let's do this. So this is a 10-year-old laptop. The battery doesn't work anymore. Here we go, guys. I don't even know if it's working or not. It's running. Okay, you ready? This is the moment. Oh my god. Is it even gonna be able to launch the game? I had to wait 3 minutes for this to launch. This is gonna be so fun. Come on, don't take too long though. Come on. Okay, that was fast enough. Now it's getting faster. It's over. Okay, so the longest move took 7 seconds and the average move took 2.6 seconds. But you know what? Given that this is so old and it's a laptop, I think I'll take it. Even if it fails, this is how slow it's gonna get ever, 2.6 seconds per move. And I think I'm okay with that. So yeah, it's not... we can't celebrate, but I don't mind. So there's a little surprise, which is I have 100 euros, guys. I have 100 euros, and you know what that means, right? We're gonna build a Steam page. So let's do it. It's gonna be temporary, so even if it's not perfect, it just needs to be good enough. Again, it's just temporary, but for now it's pretty good. So you just got these 5 screenshots because that's what they ask you. And it's got the like logo over here and then just a short description over here. In this episode, we got a basic implementation of the AI running. In the next episode, I want to build a good framework for a dialogue system that will work with multiple languages. Also, I made 30 new pieces of artwork for cards. My goal is to have 100 unique cards before the demo. So, we're looking good.